working in bio-nationalization polytechnic university in Peru City. Our department called the Center of Experimental Mechanics. This is our staff. The center is equipped with 11 different test systems. We have a good set of different accelerometers and accessories and special grips for providing different tests. Also, we have three diagnostic systems. It's a DIC system, acoustic emission, and infrared system. We are providing tests of structural materials such as steels, glass, and carbon fibers composites, reinforcing elements of composites, and we deal with functional materials, for example, shape memory materials, surgery, and covering materials. Also, we are working with structural elements made of composites. We provide in different quasi-static tests, cyclic tests, dynamic and fracture toughness tests. So, in each mechanical process, we can find some critical state. For example, in mechanical tests, it corresponds to maximum load of the test. So after this point, we have a post-critical behavior of material. In literature, you can find a lot of examples of post-critical behavior in tests, in mechanical tests, in simulation tests, and for different levels. For example, it's test results for grains, simulation for crystals of cuprum, test results of samples with initial crack lengths, and simulation of behavior, post-critical behavior of structure. For analyzing of post-critical behavior of materials, it's possible to use a constitutive relation in this form. In a softening region, there is components of softening modulus tensor, and with using of contact type boundary condition, which include coefficients of stiffness or coefficients of compliance of loading system, it possible to formulate the criteria of stable post-critical deformation is this form. Here we have parameters of deformable body, of softening region F, and parameters of loading system. Here you can see geometrical interpretation of this criteria. For example, in test we have only we can consider only two elements. First one, it's only test part of sample. Second one, it's other parts of sample and other parts of loading machine. So we can two cases of deformation of the system is possible. In first situation, when we have high stiffness of loading system, it's possible to we have full strain curve or loading curve with post-critical deformation stage. In other case, when we have low stiffness of loading system, we have only part of post-critical deformation. And if you know shape of post-critical deformation stage, and no stiffness or loading system, it's possible to forecast the moment of failure. It's very important that failure of material on post-critical stage of deformation depends on loading conditions. So we have a lot of test information about post-critical behavior of different steels at room temperature under tension, in tension torsion test, at high temperatures, and it's important that all post-critical stage of deformation is stable, because we can stop the process of deformation and realize unloadings in each point in each dose of post-critical deformation stage. In this work, we used two structural steels. Here you can see a sketch of a sample for high temperature test and example of produced sample. Electromechanical test system in Strohn was used in our tests. For high temperature tests, this system consists of loading frame, cold grips, high temperature furnace, and cooling system, thermocouples, and high temperature extensometer. So in the results of this, we have a strain curve of these steels for different temperatures, and from this data we have a mixed set of mechanical properties of materials. It's convenient for analyzing of these properties. It's convenient to use spider graphs. Each color line corresponds to test under one temperature. During the test, we realized that in condition of room temperature, it's not big difference when we realize different strain rates. But at high temperature, for example, 500 degrees, we have big differences. Big differences in post-critical behavior. When we use a different rate of tension. So it means that rheological behavior of steels take place. we realized a test of kinematic tension. It's part of active tension and part of exposition under constant elongation. Here you can see the time of exposition on each steps, test temperatures, and the time of heating and exposition at each temperatures. Here you can see results of our tests at different temperatures for this steel. Solid line here, it's loading curves, and dashed line corresponds to the values to which the load decreased during the exposition for the first 250 seconds. As you can see, post-critical behavior and this level depend on temperature of test and level of post-critical deformation. Here you can see the dependencies of non-dimensional load versus time of exposition for different stages of elastoplastic stage of deformation and for post-critical stage of deformation. You can see that the intensity of relaxation of the load depends on level of post-critical deformation. Here you can see the same results for same elongation of 3 millimeters for different temperatures, and you can see that intensity of relaxation depends on temperature and depends on velocity of previously active tension at the same temperature. Finally, the test results is shown as independence of non-dimensional load versus post-critical level of post-critical deformation, and you can see this result for different temperatures. In conclusions, I can say that the test procedure of carrying out the rheological test at the post-critical deformation stage at high temperature was realized. Test results under exposition at various stages of post-critical deformation were obtained, and it is shown that increasing of the degree of post-critical deformation leads to magnification of intensity of the relaxation processes, and this effect is more pronounced with growing temperature of tests. Okay, thank you for your attention.
We have time.